In this video, I'm going to show you how to send MQTT messages using the Raspberry Pi, and then I'll go on to show you how to use the Raspberry Pi as the broker of MQTT messages.
Okay, so I've got my Raspberry Pi here that is reading the potentiometer value from this industrial controller using Modbus TCP. So what I want to do is to use the Raspberry Pi as an MQTT client to publish an MQTT message to a broker in the cloud based on the position of this potentiometer. And then I'll have my Epic controller here subscribe to that topic in the cloud as an MQTT client and switch on this light when it receives the message published by the Raspberry Pi. Okay, so in order for us to be able to use MQTT in our Windows 10 IoT Core application, we must first install the package that enables us to do that. And then when the installation is complete, we go to our C# file. And then we add the necessary assembly reference. And then after that, I'll add my method for sending the MQTT message. Okay, so basically what I'm doing here is that I'm creating a new MQTT client using these two instructions here. And then this instruction here is for putting the options for your MQTT broker. And here we'll be putting the URL and port number of our broker in the cloud. And then this instruction here is to connect to the broker. So this here is my message builder. I'm using the topic Raspberry Pi MQTT Demo /setpoint. And then I'm sending a payload of 1 or 2, which is what we're going to be using to switch on the light on the Epic controller. And then finally, I publish my message. Now for my cloud broker, I'm going to be using the Hive MQ, public MQTT broker. So if you navigate to this URL here, and then you scroll down, and then you can get your broker URL here. And then you put it here. And then you can optionally specify your port. Okay, so we've got our method for sending MQTT messages set up now. And then here on my Epic controller, I'm simply running a Node-RED flow that subscribes to the same topic on the Hive MQ broker. And then it sends that payload to the digital output of the controller. So if it's a 1, it will switch it on. If it's a 0, it will remain off. And then I deploy. So now we go to our method for reading Modbus data. And then here we say if the Modbus result is greater than 25, we send an MQTT message. Okay, so that's it. Now let's run our application. Now, if I turn up my port to be above 25%, we should see the light come on. There we go. Now, instead of using the cloud as the MQTT broker, we can actually have our Raspberry Pi run as the broker. Now, to do that, I'll add my server method here. So basically here I'm specifying the port number for my server, and then I'm creating the MQTT server, and then this basically is a routine that is performed when a message is received, and then this is what is performed when a connection is detected. And then I'll start my MQTT server here, and then I'll just start my server on initialization. And then I'll just point the MQTT client on my Epic controller to the Raspberry Pi instead of the cloud. And then we can use an MQTT client like MQTT.fx to send our message. And then we publish the message. Thanks for watching. If you've got any thoughts at all on this video, I would love to hear about it in the comment section below. And if you found the video useful, Please share it with your connections and don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this.